There's never enough time. You want to exercise, eat healthy, be in shape, but the day slips by and you don't go to the gym. You eat that muffin for lunch instead of the salad that you thought you would. You want to do great work, advance your career, and produce something meaningful, but your email inbox is overflowing. A coworker drops by to ask a quick question. Soon the workday is done and you're exactly where you were the day before. You want to learn a language, you want to learn to play guitar, or paint, or do martial arts. If you could just put the time in consistently, you would make it happen and you would learn that skill. But it stops more than it starts, and years go by, and it remains just a notion. So how do you find time? Well, the first thing to do is to realize that time is rarely the problem. Yes, time is limited, but attention, energy, and enthusiasm are more limited than that. So your first step should be to make habits. Even spending a few minutes a day to get started with something can often accumulate to a huge amount over time. The second thing is to realize is that a list of unfulfilled things to do that you don't have time for is not a problem to actually eliminate. You have to prioritize. It's our nature as human beings that we live finite lives amongst near infinite possibilities, and that choosing which things you're going to do with your life is as much a decision as being able to do certain things. So thus, you must prioritize your goals. Say no to things that don't meet your criteria, and say no to things even that you don't realize you're saying yes to right now. Again, it's not so much all the other goals that are pushing out the time in your schedule, but all the things that you don't even realize that you are implicitly agreeing to do. The television you're implicitly agreeing to watch, the internet you're implicitly agreeing to surf, the little things that you're saying yes to when you could be saying yes to something else. The third thing to realize is that fears and frustrations are ultimately what are driving your sense of when you have time. That I don't have time becomes a convenient excuse to cover up the fact that this sounds frustrating, this sounds scary. So thus, put your fears first. If something is important, do it. If it is unpleasant, do it now. Facing down the things that scare you has the unintended effect that those same things turn out to be not so scary after all, that thing that you were afraid of starting turns out to be not so bad. That thing that you were worried about getting rejection on turns out you aren't going to get that negative feedback. That many times the thing that you imagine being so awful or scary or hard to contemplate ends up being a lot easier in the doing. So the truth is that you have the time. Not for everything, but for the things that matter. Maybe you only have a few minutes each day, then use those few minutes. Maybe it's fragmented time. It's when you're distracted and it's prone to interruption. Then let it be distracted. Let it be fragmented. Let it be something that you only have little moments that you have to capture between all the other things that you have to do. Just don't let it slip away unknowingly. Don't let it be another day that goes by where you worked on things that don't really matter to you.